It's AumSum time!
What if cakes disappeared?
Oh no! I love to eat cakes!
Oh, AumSum.
To buy this sweatshirt, visit AumSum.com.
Firstly, if cakes disappeared, birthdays may not remain that interesting anymore. Secondly, if cakes disappeared, pastry chefs may have to look for a new profession. Thirdly, if cakes disappeared, some people may start cutting chocolates or ice creams during birthdays. Fourthly, cakes are generally not considered to be healthy. If cakes disappeared, some people may actually start losing some weight. Lastly, if cakes disappear, sale of birthday candles may go down.
What if burgers disappear?
Oh no! Now what will I eat?
Oh, AumSum. Firstly, burgers are generally considered to be not good for health. If burgers disappeared, many people may actually lose weight. Secondly, if burgers disappeared, sale of bread may also plummet. Thirdly, if burgers disappear, people who love burgers may actually go on a hunger strike. Fourthly, if burgers disappeared, sale of pizzas may skyrocket. Fifthly, burgers are generally considered to have a lot of calories. If burgers disappeared, dietitians would be one happy lot. Lastly, after a long workout session, some people love to have a small cheat meal. If burgers disappeared, these people would be mightily disappointed.
What if pizza disappeared?
Oh no! I just opened an AumSum pizza store!
Oh, AumSum. Firstly, if pizza disappeared, some people might actually start losing weight. Secondly, many people love to eat pizza. If pizza disappeared, many people may actually start eating more at home. Thirdly, pizza is said to have been invented in Italy. If pizza disappeared, entire country may go on strike. Fourthly, if pizza disappeared, pizza delivery guys will have a lot of free time on their hands. Fifthly, cheese and pizza go hand in hand. If pizza disappeared, sale of cheese may come down. Lastly, if pizza disappeared, fast food joints world over may start closing up.
What if French fries disappeared?
No problem. I will launch tasty AumSum fries.
Oh, AumSum. Firstly, French fries are extremely popular at McDonald's. If French fries disappeared, sales at McDonald's may go down. Secondly, French fries are generally considered to be not good for health. If French fries disappeared, some people may actually lose weight. Thirdly, if French fries disappeared, French people may go on strike. Fourthly, if French fries disappeared, sale of potatoes may see a sharp downturn. Lastly, many people love to eat French fries with ketchup. If French fries disappeared, sale of ketchup may go down.
Is sugar bad for you?
No, because whenever I eat sugar, I get sweet treats.
All right, now listen. If we consume a lot of sugar, then it can lead to serious health problems. For example, a hormone called leptin tells our brain when to stop eating. However, consuming excess fructose, which is a type of sugar, can cause leptin resistance, a condition in which our brain does not respond to leptin. Hence, we overeat, resulting in obesity. Moreover, excess sugar is converted into a type of fat called triglycerides. Triglycerides can enter the bloodstream and form fatty deposits or plaques in blood vessels, increasing the risk of heart attack, stroke, etc. Excess sugar can even bind to collagen and elastin in our skin, damaging them and thus making our skin saggy and wrinkly. Studies have also shown that women who have one or more sugary drinks per day are more likely to develop diabetes. Is it bad to hold our urine?
Dude, right now I'm not in a state to answer you.
Okay, I'll explain. Our body has various ways to get rid of unwanted waste materials. One of these ways is through urine. Urine is a liquid waste consisting of unwanted materials like water, salts, urea, uric acid, etc. The urinary system consists of two kidneys, two ureters, a urinary bladder, and a urethra. The two kidneys filter blood and produce urine, which flows through the ureters and starts getting collected in the urinary bladder. When our urinary bladder starts getting full and it begins to stretch or expand, the nerves of the bladder inform the brain to produce an urge to urinate. Now, when we want to urinate, the bladder contracts and the urine flows out of the body through the urethra. Once in a while, it's okay to hold our urine, but stress and pressures of modern life make us hold our urine more often and for longer periods, which can have negative effects on our health. For example, a wet and warm bladder of urine is the perfect breeding ground for harmful bacteria. Hence, if we don't empty the bladder regularly, then the bacteria are more likely to grow and multiply, causing urinary tract infection or UTI. Holding the urine can also cause the bladder to remain expanded or stretched for too long. This may make it difficult for the bladder to contract normally while urinating. As a result, the bladder will not be emptied completely, which can lead to discomfort, pain, and other serious problems. Sometimes, the excess urine in bladder can even flow back to the kidneys, causing kidney damage or kidney infection. In very rare cases, the bladder may even burst, risking the life of the individual. How do we know that our stomach is full? Usually, our stomach and brain are constantly communicating with each other with the help of hormones and nerves. So, when our stomach is empty and the glucose level in our blood is low, the stomach produces a hormone called ghrelin. Ghrelin generally travels to the brain through blood and informs the brain that we need to eat and thus we feel hungry. Now, when we eat food to satisfy our hunger, the food enters our stomach, causing its walls to stretch and expand. When this happens, the nerves on the stomach walls detect the expansion and tell the brain that our stomach is full and our hunger is satisfied. However, our stomach also expands when we drink a lot of water. But in this case, our hunger is not satisfied. Do you know why? This is because there is one more method by which our brain can identify whether we are eating food or just drinking water. Can you guess what that method is? Alright, I'll tell you. As mentioned earlier, our stomach and brain constantly communicate with each other with the help of hormones. One of these hormones is cholecystokinin. When we begin to eat, nutrients in food stimulate the release of cholecystokinin, which eventually enters the bloodstream. It is the presence of this cholecystokinin in the blood which informs the brain that we are eating food and not just drinking water. Now, as we eat more food, more cholecystokinin is released, informing our brain that our stomach is getting full with food, and thus, the brain needs to suppress the desire to eat. Last but not least, did you know that boiled potatoes are the most hunger-satisfying foods? So, next time if you are hungry, try them and find out the truth. How do stars form? Stars are like huge balls of fire that emit a tremendous amount of heat and light. Stars don't form in a few seconds, minutes, or hours. Star formation process is so slow that it can take millions of years. A star begins its life inside vast molecular clouds of dust and gas. These molecular clouds are also known as nebulae or dark nebulae. They mostly contain hydrogen and helium molecules along with some other particles. Normally, these molecular clouds are cold and stable. However, a nearby supernova explosion or galactic collision may send a shockwave or tremendous amount of energy through a molecular cloud. Now, in the molecular cloud, this energy causes a gravitational disturbance due to which it begins to collapse on itself under its own gravity, causing hydrogen and helium to clump together and thus increasing the mass in the center of the cloud. This increase in mass increases the gravitational pull, thus attracting even more molecules and particles from the surrounding. As more and more molecules and particles collapse or fall into the center of the cloud, the center begins to heat up. This heated center, or heated core, is known as a protostar. A protostar continues to pull more molecules and gets hotter and hotter until the temperature and pressure reach to such an extent that hydrogen nuclei begin to fuse with one another, producing helium and releasing heat, light, and radiation. This process is called nuclear fusion. When this happens, the inward force of gravity is exactly balanced by the outward force created by heat and radiation. These inward and outward forces maintain balance, and thus, a star is born.